All right, everybody, thank you for your patience. Appreciate it. And thanks for being here. I'm Karen McPherson, the Children's and Teen Librarian at the Takoma Park, Maryland Library. And we are thrilled to welcome all of you to this event, which is in coordination sponsorship with Politics and Prose Bookstore. That's how we get to have all these great authors. So we are particularly excited because this is a book that's hugely popular in our library. So to welcome this author and her daughters, who also do the books with her, is a really big treat. Just briefly, I wanted to mention that I read a little bit about Rachel Renee Russell, the main author today, and I feel like she's proof you should never give up your dreams. When Rachel took a creative writing class as a college student at Northwestern University, a professor told her that she should really never, ever seriously consider writing. So she decided instead to become a bankruptcy lawyer, and she did that very well for many years. But she never really gave up that dream of writing, and in 2007, she started writing seriously again, which is pretty cool. And we all sort of know what happened after that. The first Dork Diaries book was published in 2009, so that's 5 years ago. Millions and millions of these books have been sold since then, and there's movies in the works at this point. And tonight, we are thrilled to go ahead and launch book number 8. So let me introduce Rachel Renee Russell, Erin Russell, and Niki Russell.
Good evening, everyone.
Hi.
Take this out of here and hold on to it. You guys look wonderful. As you just heard, I'm Rachel Renee Russell. I'm going to stand up so I can see you guys better. I'm Rachel Renee Russell, and I'm the author of Dork Diaries. And thank you. And I'm very, very happy to be here today to meet you guys. And I'm a very, very lucky mom because I get to work full time with my dorky daughter number one, Erin, and dorky daughter number two, Niki. Okay, you guys can have a seat. So anyway, we're going to just do a really quick 30-minute presentation, and basically, you know, very informal. We're going to answer questions, and you're welcome to ask me a question, my daughter Erin a question, or Niki. Erin is my co-author, and Nikki's my illustrator, and I'll just tell you kind of a little story how all this started. I always wanted to be an author. As you heard, I was kind of discouraged to do that when I took a couple of creative writing classes and for children back in college, so I decided instead to become an attorney. So after my daughters grew up and they were very, very dorky, I'd say about 80% of what you read in Dork Diaries is true. So all of those like very funny stories, those very horrible stories, and those very weird stories, for the most part, more than likely came from some incident that either one of them experienced. But anyway, I did write the first Dork Diaries and illustrate it pretty much by myself. The book was a big hit, and people were reading it. And at that point, my publisher had initially requested one book a year, but they thought, wow, let's do 2 books a year. So they called and said, oh, well, Rachel, we want 2 books a year. Can you do that? And I thought, sure, I can do that, even though it was a struggle just, you know, writing the one book because I was working by myself. So what I did, I thought, wow, they want me to do 2 books a year. What am I going to do? What am I going to do? So at that point, dorky daughter number 2, Erin, had just graduated from University of Michigan. And guess what she had a degree in? Or guess what her profession is? Does any of you know? Do any of you know? Yes, in the red.
Writing.
Not writing. A good guess, though. What profession do you think she was in? Yes.
Editing?
No. Yep, in the blue. She was an elementary school teacher. Was it second grade? Oh, Niki, I'm calling her Erin, see? Only two kids and I get them mixed up. So this is Niki, I'm sorry. Thank you, Erin. Thank you. So Niki, dorky daughter number two, Niki had just graduated from college and she had just landed a job teaching in elementary school. And as I don't know if any of you are teachers or principals, but it's really hard your first few years out to land a job. And Niki got right out of school and got a job right away. So anyway, I called her and I said, how are things going with your class? She says, oh, wonderful. She's like, how is the book going? And I said, oh, it's terrible. I have to write 2 books a year. There's no way I can write 2 books a year. Would you please quit your job and come help me illustrate Dork Diaries? And guess what she said? She said yes. So by about our third book, Niki joined me, and ever since then, she's been illustrating them. So if you look at Dork Diaries book one, and then if you look at like two, and all the way through what, book eight, the art looks a lot better. That's because she's drawing, and she's a lot better than I am. So anyway, that's the story of how Niki joined. So Niki's been with me since probably what, 2010, 2011, or thereabout. So I had an illustrator, but I still had to do all of that writing by myself. And I thought, what am I going to do? There's no way I can write all these books by myself. I can't write 2 books a year. I've got an illustrator, so we're going to get the illustrations done on time. And I thought, wow, my other daughter, Erin, graduated from University of Michigan, and she majored in creative writing. I thought, wow, that might come in handy. So by that time, Erin had, we were originally from Michigan, so she had moved from Michigan to Iowa, and she was working for a mortgage company at that point, not using her creative writing skills. And I called her one day, and I was like, oh, how's your job going? And she's like, oh, fine. Well, how are the Dork Diaries books going? And I said, terrible! I have to write 2 books a year, and there's just no way I can write 2 books a year. Will you please, please, please quit your job and come and help your poor mom write Dork Diaries books? And guess what she said? Yes! So I ended up with a co-author and an illustrator, and we were able to manufacture and write and get 2 books out per year. So it's still very, very hard, and it's a grinding schedule, but we were able to do it, the three of us. So that's kind of the story of how Erin and Niki ended up working. I kind of tricked them a little bit, maybe. But I had to give them raises, though. They told me I had to, like, significantly increase their incomes, and that's fine. I'm doing a lot better than that now. But so anyway, I really consider myself a lucky mom because I get to work with my daughters, and I think they might like working with me. I don't know. Yeah, they're being nice and saying yes. So anyway, at this point, I'd like to open it up to questions and answers. So if you have a question, you can either line up at the microphone on this aisle or line up at the microphone in that aisle. And it can be either kids or adults. You know, we'd be happy to. So, yep, just feel free to pop in line behind the microphone. And you can ask either myself a question, Erin, or Niki. And before we do that, I want to introduce two special people that came with me today. My first is Don here? Has he stepped out? Where's Don? Oh, that's my brother, Don. And why Don is so special to me is because I wrote my first book when I was like in fourth grade, and it was called The Ronnie and Donnie Book, and it was dedicated to him. So you can say, hi, Don. Exactly, thank you. So he was the inspiration for my first book when I was a kid. The second person that's with me today is this very special, is my sister, and I stole her from the corporate department of Dell. It worked with Erin and Niki, so I called and did the same spiel with her. So she is now my manager and my marketing person and my PR person, and her name is Kim, and she's my sister. Yay. So say hi, Kim. Hello. Okay, so you guys ready? Okay, let's start over here. And you're in purple. Yes. Very cool. Okay, if you could tell me your name and your question. And feel free to ask a question. It could be for me, Erin, or Niki.
Okay, so my name is Camila. And my question was, is this series like only generated off your daughter's experiences in school or also off of yours?
Yeah, that is a very good question. I would say we throw a little bit of my life in there every once in a while, but I would say about 80% of it would be Erin and Niki, and maybe 20%, you know, from me. I was very dorky too. My dad paid my prom date. He did. It was a family friend, and he gave him like $100 to do it, and then he loaned him our Eldorado Cadillac to drive. And he probably gave him money for the restaurant too. I came out okay. I'm okay. I got married and had kids, you know. So yeah, I would say the majority of the book is based on Erin and Niki, but there are a few things in there, you know,
your
about
musical?
Me. Oh, but Dork Diaries book 3 was Erin, the talent show. When I was little, I don't know if you've ever heard of the Apollo Theater. That's like this theater in New York City that's like old school. Well, when I was little, I was the piano player. I had a middle sister named Demita. She played the bass and lead guitar. And then Kim was the drummer. And we went to the Apollo Theater, and we won like three or four times.
So
Erin is very correct. Our Dork Diaries tells from a not so talented pop star was inspired by my experiences as a child. You know, being Jackson 5 had come out, and then Sister Sledge and the DeBarge back in the dinosaur age. But so, okay, and I'm gonna explain what Niki is doing. Niki is doing what we call dorkifications, and what she is going to do is peek at members of the audience, and she's going to draw you in the Dork Diary style, and then you'll be able to take your artwork home with you. Okay, so just keep smiling and. Okay, next we'll go back to over here.
Thank you.
I'm Sophia, and I was wondering if Mackenzie is real.
Okay, I know the perfect person who can answer that question for you.
I wish she were a myth like the boogeyman, but unfortunately, she's real. Her real name shall not be uttered today. We don't want her to show up. She used to be our neighbor. I think our whole Niki and my whole school career. And she was about as evil as her too. She grew powerful off of other people's pain and didn't like dorks very well. But who's laughing now? Thank you.
Okay, next, could you tell us your name, please, and then your question?
My name is Julia, and I want to ask, was the main character, Niki, based off your daughter, your real other daughter?
Yes, as a matter of fact, I initially was going to name the older daughter, Erin, and the younger daughter, Niki, but at the time, Erin was like, oh, Mom, I don't really know how I feel about that. Now she thinks it's pretty cool. So we're doing going to be launching a new book series called Locker Boy, and the main girl character is going to be named Erin after this Erin. But yes, Niki Maxwell is named after Niki, and Brianna is the name that if I had had a third daughter, I would have named her Brianna. So, and Brianna is really, 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 really a lot like Niki, because Niki was a kid. She was like spastic and very, very busy. So, good question. Okay, next.
My name is Lucy, and I was wondering if the Dork Diaries were going to be made into a movie.
Okay, do you want to? I'll let you answer that one.
The answer is yes! And we're really excited about that. Mom can give you some details.
She's going to give the question back to me. Okay, yes. The Dork Diaries film rights were just optioned by Lionsgate in like April of this year. If you're not familiar with Lionsgate films, they did Hunger Games. They did Twilight. And they did Divergent. So next will be Dork Diaries. So we've been told that they have an expected release date of 2016, so we have a long time to kind of wait, you know, well, maybe what, a few more months of this year, and then all of 2015, and then in 2016 hopefully they will be releasing it. And I've heard that they're casting and working on scripts right now. So yes, there will be a Dork Diaries movie, hopefully. Good question. Yes?
I'm Elizabeth, and how come Chloe and Zoe don't seem very afraid of balls anymore?
Do you want to answer that, Niki? Okay. And you heard the question? Mm-hmm. Okay.
So the So the question was, how come Chloe and Zoe are not so scared of balls anymore? Well, I can answer that for you. Ever since they became friends with Niki Maxwell, they were able to embrace their very own inner dork, and it made them a whole lot braver. And so whenever they hang out together and go to gym class, they rely on each other to stay strong and confident and encouraged, and that is how they survived the volleyball class in our newest book. You can notice that they stuck together the whole time. Dorks of a feather stick together.
Thank you, Niki.
You're welcome.
Okay, next question.
My name's Jessica, and I had a question for Niki.
Okay.
Okay, I'm back.
Do you like illustrating the Dork Diaries books?
I love, 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 love illustrating Dork Diaries books. As a teacher, I never would have imagined that I would go from that to doing what I enjoy and do naturally, doodle. So now I get to doodle 24/7, and on top of that, I also still embrace my life as a teacher because I get to come out and speak to you all. So it couldn't be better. I really enjoy and adore my job, and I'm really grateful my mommy gave it to me. Thank you for asking.
Okay, and next over here.
I'm Aria, and I was wondering, which is your favorite Dork Diaries book?
Okay, why don't we all answer that? My favorite Dork Diaries book, I always have two favorites. My first favorite is always the first book, book number one. And I think that is so special to me because I was just sitting at home thinking of all of these funny, crazy things and remembering a lot of the events, some happy, some sad, that happened to my two daughters, and just stuffing that all into book one. And it ended up selling, and you know, so book one is always my favorite. My second favorite book is always the current book that I'm working on. So since we just finished Dork Diaries book 8, which is Tales from a Not So Happily Ever After, I would say that is my favorite book. And aren't these cool? We just had these, actually my sister, see, she's good. She had these made, and when I look at them, it's just, oh, it's so cool. It almost feels like it's a movie or something. But so I would say book one is my favorite, and then second favorite would be Dork Diaries book number 8.
Like my mom, I think my favorite would be book number 1, just because it was so refreshing to see a girl dork book. So with that new concept, it was cool, and then it was very funny, and the original, it's hard to knock the original. It's always going to be number one, and but this current book is gorgeous. I love it. So this is my favorite cover.
Well, being a romantic at heart, just like Chloe, my favorite books happen to be Dork Diaries number, is it 6? Because Niki gets to get all dolled up, and she looks beautiful like a princess, and gets to go to a dance party with Brandon. And now I am torn between book 7 and book 8. Do you all know what happens at book 7? That's just OMG. Niki and Brandon share their kiss. So there's that. And I'm
yeah, what? After the fact. Yeah, that's okay.
Sorry. But yes, so if you read book 7, you'll find out that for the very first time, Brandon gives Niki a kiss for their Kiss and Hugs charity. And it's a really sweet thing because Niki likes Brandon. And then there's book eight, so I'm torn between these two books. In book eight, Brandon is Prince Charming, and she... Okay, you can find out yourselves when you read the book.
As you see, she gets really excited about talking about the books. Yeah, thank you both. Okay, we are over here now, okay?
My name is Willow, and I was wondering, why did you start writing the series?
Why did I start writing the series? I always wanted to be an author. I wanted to be an author instead of an attorney. But when I was like your age, I would write books for Christmas presents. It was nice because it was also free. I didn't have to like babysit and spend my money. I could just go get pieces of paper and write a really cool story, staple it, wrap it in wrapping paper, and give it to people. And most of the time, they liked it. So I just loved writing, and I started writing when I was, you know, very, very young. And that was what I wanted to do. But after I got older and went to college and took a couple of classes, I was told that I was not very good at it. So I was like, oh, well. So I went on to law school and whatever. But after my daughters grew up and went off to college, I had extra time on my hands. So I thought, I need a really cool hobby. What hobby can I do now that I have all this extra time since my kids are kind of grown up? And I thought, maybe I'll start writing again. So that's kind of what inspired me, was having the time. And so I went online and I joined a writer's group, and it was maybe about a dozen authors, and nobody was published, but we all wanted to be published. So we would write chapters of the book that we're working on, then we would send it to each other. And when I sent mine out, I would just get all this email saying it was so funny, and I laughed till I cried, and my niece read it and she wants the rest of the book, and you should submit this to a literary agent. So I thought, wow, maybe I am good at this after all. So I sent some pages to a literary agent, and he loved them, and the rest is kind of history. So that's how it all came about.
What inspired it to be a diary-themed book?
What inspired it to be a diary-themed book? Because when I was younger, my favorite book was Harriet the Spy. Any parents remember Harriet the Spy? Harriet the Spy was a diary. And Harriet would spy on the kids in her class, and she'd write it down. And one day she lost her diary, and the kids in her class read it, and it was horrible, horrible, horrible. So anyway, I love that book. Also, as I got older, probably by high school, I read The Diary of Anne Frank. Oh, it's just heart-wrenching. And, of course, there was Princess Diaries. I was, by that time, I think I was married and had a couple of kids, but I was still reading teen books. So all of the books that I've always loved most were diaries. And with diaries, you can speak in first person, which means you can kind of get inside the character. And if they're happy, they can go squee, and, you know, I'm so happy, blah, blah, blah. Or if they're sad, they can say, oh, my gosh, I can't believe it. So I loved writing in first person in the diary format. And it just really worked for me. And it's a lot of fun. Even when I am at home writing by myself, I really enjoy what I'm doing. So that's kind of a long-winded answer to your question. Yes?
Who inspired the character Brandon?
I will let Darky Daughter number one answer that one.
Okay, so I have this reputation of having these huge crushes, and my mom knew all about them. And so Brandon was based on my biggest crush in high school. And every time he would walk by, my heart would stop. And yeah, so he is like a cross between my crush at the time and the perfect boyfriend.
Thank you, Erin. And over here, I believe? Or over, which side, over here? Over here? Yeah. Okay. I'm sorry. Yes, dear.
My name is Kayla, and I was wondering what inspired you to make the annoying little sister Brina.
Oh, the annoying little sister Brianna was inspired by Niki. I will tell you a real quick story. When my husband and I purchased a new home, and Erin had a room, and she wanted hers pink. pink and pastel, and Niki wanted hers baby blue. So I painted, and we bought new carpet and new bedspreads and comforters and all that. So I presented Erin her room. She's like, thank you, Mommy, that was wonderful. And when I presented Niki's room, she's like, Mom, there's something missing here. And I'm like, oh, well, what is it? Well, you step out of the room, Mommy, and I'm going to fix the room so it looks a lot better. And I'm like, oh, okay. And I thought, well, maybe she's going to put her toys and her Barbies in there. So she called me back about 10 minutes later, and she had taken a black magic marker almost as thick as this microphone and drawn all over the walls. So when I said, Niki, I just spent all this money and all this time making you the perfect baby blue bedroom. Why did you do that? And she says, Mom, I'm practicing because when I grow up, I'm going to be an artist. And you know what? She was absolutely correct. So. So yes, that's a lot of the crazy and wacky things and the energy and the humor that you read with my Brianna character is pretty much Niki. I mean, pretty much Niki. And the Niki Maxwell character is pretty much Erin, though the names are kind of, you know, switched around a little bit. But good question. And over here?
So I was wondering, did all of those really horrific things in the books happen to either Erin or Niki, like when Niki got locked in the closet in the ice skating book?
Okay, that, I would say about 80% of what you read in the book is correct. That is what we kind of just made up. Erin and I were thinking, we need something really exciting. What evil, evil thing can Mackenzie do to Zoe, Chloe, and Niki? So no, that we made up.
And also, are you going to write more of these books? Or
Yes. As a matter of fact, we're already working on Dork Diaries Book 9. And we are in talks with our publisher, Simon & Schuster, for the next two books. So, and with the movie coming out, that's really good. So hopefully there will be more Dork Diaries for at least maybe the next 5 years or so, hopefully. So, yeah, good question. Yes?
I wanted to know if Erin was Chloe or Zoe.
Okay, do you want to answer that? Who are you more like?
I think out of the two, I was more like Zoe. She's more of the thoughtful or like book smart one. And Niki is very, like she said, she's a romantic, and she's always so optimistic. And so, yeah, I'm like Zoe, and Niki is like Chloe.
Thank you. Okay, we'll kind of go maybe just 5 minutes, and then we'll get started on the book signing. So, okay, and we're over here now.
Well, my name is Ellen, and my question is, do you have any other siblings other than the ones you just introduced?
Okay, I have two daughters, and they are both here, Erin and Niki. If I had had a third child, I would have named the child Brianna. So that's where I came up with the Brianna name, because I like that. But I have two children, Erin and Niki. Okay, thank you. Oh, I'm sorry. Thank you. She's looking at me like, that lady's nuts. Okay, I'm sorry, dear. Siblings, duh. I have a law degree. You wouldn't think it, though. Okay, siblings. Yes, I have four other brothers and sisters. I'm the oldest. There's five in our family. So I'm the oldest. The next is my sister, Demita, and she's a dentist. Next is Kim that you met over there. Next is my twin, Don's twin brother, and his name is Ron. And then the baby of the family is Don, who's sitting there. So I had four other brothers and sisters, and very good question. And I apologize for kind of, you know, having a senior moment there, not quite understanding. Okay, and where are we at now? Over there? But thank you for clarifying that. Yes?
My name is Kate, and did you really dress up Max the Roach for Christmas?
Max the Roach It would be part of our fiction part. We did make up the Max the Roach part. So there was nobody dressing up Max the Roach. Yes?
My name is Nadia, and I have two questions. Mm-hmm. One of them is, did you pick the name Niki because she's your daughter, or did you just want to?
Yes, I picked the name Niki because of my older daughter, Niki. I would have had it, Erin would have been the older daughter, and Niki would have been the younger daughter, but in the end, we just went with Niki, and then Erin's going to be in our the name of our main character in our next book.
And I have a question for Niki. Who would you like better, Zoe or Chloe?
Oh my goodness, it's so hard to choose because they're both such dear, loyal friends to Niki. I think I like them both. Is that an okay answer? Thank you.
Okay, yes?
I'm Sila, and my question was, you never say like what grade she's in the books, mm-hmm. So.
I think she's in eighth grade in middle school. Yeah. Oh, another thing, because you guys have asked several questions about stuff that was true. Do you want to kind of name off some of the things that were true in the book? Because they mentioned there's no Max the Roach, and there's no, Mackenzie didn't really lock anybody in the locker. Do you want to name some of the stuff that is actually true?
Okay, let's see if I can remember. We did go to a private school. I lost my lunch, not because I was sick, but because someone tripped me, so that part is true.
That's in book one.
And then the having a crush, that was a big part of my life. And I also wrote in a diary about him every day.
Newspaper.
I was on the newspaper staff. And I write and draw. So Nikki's drawing abilities is based on the real Niki and also on me. Oh yeah, and we're also into doodling. So all of those little drawings in the diaries, we had notebooks full of doodles. Can you name any?
In book four, it's kind of like the holiday one or the winter one, and there in the Niki and Brianna go down a really big hill. That's real. We're from Michigan, so there's a lot of snow. It's like winter in Michigan, like 10 months of the year practically. Maybe I'm exaggerating, but so when they go on down this big hill and it's like really crazy, that was inspired by them actually doing things like that. Can you think of stuff, Niki?
I almost forgot Crazy Grandma. We have a crazy grandma.
You have two crazy grandmas.
Yeah, yeah.
And both are currently back in Michigan right now.
And she wants, one of them wants to take belly dancing lessons. Mm-hmm. That would be so embarrassing if she came to your school.
Can you think of things that are correct?
Okay, well, remember the trapped inside the closet incident? Mm-hmm. I can actually vividly recall this one time I was in high school, and I just got through with theater class, yes. And you're right. The school was closing down, right? So I left out of the wrong side of the auditorium. I left where the part of the hallway that usually leads out of the school was gated off, and the door locked from behind me. Mm-hmm. So here I was, this sad little person saying, help me, from behind the cage. But no one could see me, right? Because I was a dork. If they saw me, they'd start making fun of me like I was on display at a museum going, ha ha, the dork is trapped. Look at her behind the cage. So I was so scared and helpless. My mom had to come and rescue me. I had to stay hidden the whole time so nobody saw me. It just added on to my embarrassment. That actually happened.
Yeah,
it was true.
I remember that now. Technically, no, a mean girl didn't lock her in that. She was just kind of
trying to get out.
She did. She locked her own self in the closet. And I was sitting out in the parking lot and waiting. Was it theater class or something?
It was theater.
Theater, yeah. And I was waiting. And then after about 45 minutes, I thought, well, let me go in here and see where. So, and sure enough, I found her. She's like, Mom!
That was a dorky moment, if I ever do say so myself.
Yeah. So, yeah, I guess you can kind of say the closet part. Anything else you can? Oh, poor Niki never got invited to any parties when she was. And she would come and say, this person's having a party and they didn't invite me, and that person's had a party and they didn't invite me.
But the good news is that we always get invited to author and illustrator parties now, so I get to party all I want to.
Yeah, very good. Okay. Okay, so we'll take maybe four more questions and then we'll start signing books, okay? So we'll do two on this side and two on that side. And then everybody that's left, when you come up to the table, you can just ask us the questions in person. That's even better. Okay? So how are you doing on your dorkifications? One more. Okay, so let's do two questions over here and two questions over here. And again, if you have a question, hold that thought. And when you come up here for us to sign your book or to meet us, I'd be happy to answer whatever it is you were going to ask and didn't get a chance to. Okay? So yes, ma'am?
Hi, my name is Marika, and would you like pair up with anybody else to write a book, write a different book or series?
You know who I'd like to pair up with to write a book? Can you guess? I'd love to write a book jointly with Erin, Rachel Russell and Erin Russell. And I'd love to pair up and write a book with Niki, and it'd be Rachel Russell and Niki Russell. So those are my two favorite. And we've been talking about it, actually, so that might happen one day. Yes?
Again, I'm Aria, and I was wondering, which one of you three has the most humor?
Well, I don't know. What do you think?
I think Niki is the silliest. She's a kid at heart.
Yes, yeah, I would think so. Erin has, I'm going to brag a minute. Okay, Erin, her senior year in college, she was a political cartoonist at the University of Michigan for their newspaper staff. See, a lot of that stuff is true, and that Niki worked for newspaper. She worked in newspaper high school and college.
Erin.
But I said, I'm screwing up your names again, I'm sorry. Erin. Erin worked for University of Michigan's newspaper, and she wrote a political cartoon, and she was so good. How good was she? She was so good that she won the Charles Schulz Award, like the Peanuts. You know, he's deceased now, but in his memory, his estate awards, was it like $10,000 or $20,000? $10,000 to one outstanding college cartoonist. And Erin won that. She was flown to Washington, D.C., to the swanky hotel, National Press Club, and she got the award and $10,000 cash. And I think she ended up with a development deal with United Media, and they are the syndicate that publishes Peanuts and a lot of other ones. So when we say who's the funniest, Niki's fun and silly, but Erin is like wicked humor, wry, witty. So they both are like, I'm their mom. I can brag I'm their mom. But yeah, they both are wonderful daughters, and they both have like just wonderful, wonderful sense of humor. A little bit different, but they both are very talented. And that's why Dork Diaries is so funny, because, you know, I sit down with both of them, and we just have a really good time.
She took the words right out of my mouth. All three of us are funny in our own way.
Okay. So, yep, we have over here, I think.
Mm-hmm. Did you ever have any pets?
Do we have pets? I'll let you want to talk about that?
Technically, this pet would be like the third child to my mom. She's a teeny tiny teacup Yorkie with a big personality, little princess, spoiled rotten. And a lot of the time I'm working, I hear this squeaky toy and yip, 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 yip going off. Like, she'll just continue. And I'm like, Mom, aren't you supposed to be writing? And she's like, Mika won't let me write. That's her name, Mika. So yes, we have Mika. And then my sister has a little baby too. His name is Shadow, and he's a poodle. And he's really cute, and I like seeing them together. That's her nickname for him, Biscuit and Gravy, because he's black and white and gray. But yeah, thanks for the question.
Okay, and our final question of the evening.
I wanted to ask why you chose a fairy tale theme for book 8.
I chose a fairy tale theme for book 8 because we wanted to do something a little different and something that's really creative, and to put Niki Maxwell and a really fun world.
And we wanted an excuse to wear crowns.
Yes, we wanted to wear tiaras. So we thought if we made a story and we put a tiara on Niki, she's over there, I think, a tiara on Niki, then we'd have an excuse to wear tiaras at our next book signing. Thank you, Erin, for that. So, but yeah, and the other thing, too, is that there are lots of book series out that are real popular now that are based on fairy tales. So we thought that would be really cool. Okay, I think that is it. Are you ready, Niki?
Almost.
Okay.
Okay.
Okay. Okay. She's finishing up her dorkifications. And then. Are there any questions by adults at all? Moms and dads. Any questions? Yes.
Mm-hmm. Can you hear me? I teach
school. Okay.
I wonder if you could talk about the process of like making the idea and how you go through building the story and that.
Okay. That is, we're still trying to figure it out, actually. Usually we sit down and we figure out a title, and then based on the title, Erin and I will brainstorm and figure out basically a beginning, a middle, and an end. Sometimes when we're writing a book, we don't know how the book's going to end, but it's smart to kind of have an idea, but sometimes we don't. But we will sit down and brainstorm between the two of us, you know, funny incidents that actually really happen, and then we'll brainstorm, you know, just fiction incidents or fiction type things that we figure our fans would enjoy. So we do write for you guys. I will sit down and usually write a chapter, and then I will assign Erin a chapter, and then usually at the end of the week we'll kind of sit down and put them together. The biggest inspiration for me is when I have gotten a draft of a chapter, I've gotten a draft from Erin's chapter, is to give it to Niki, and Niki illustrates it. And when I get it back, I'm like, whoa, it's almost like Christmas, and I'm opening up. Just looking at her artwork is like just so inspiring. So once we have a draft of the book or the chapters, Niki illustrates them, and then we get them back, and then boom, our brains explode, and we sit down at our computers, and then we rewrite the chapters, and they're just funnier and just more exciting or whatever. So we do that all the way through the entire book. And the book is divided into, usually depends on the month, either 30 days or 31 days. But that's just kind of how it works. And when we get the first draft done, we send it to our editor. She gives us notes and we get it back and we, you know, make those changes. But I would say basically how I explain it is it's us brainstorming, making a draft. We give it to Niki to illustrate, and when we get back her illustrations, it's just takes us to a whole nother level. So that's kind of the creative process. Then yes?
I know you said you were talking, you were going to write another book called Locker Boy. Any characters of color we can look forward to?
Yes, and let me, on that note, Niki Maxwell is white, Zoe is African American, and Chloe is Latina. How many of you knew that? Raise your hand if you knew that. Nobody knew that? Yeah, so we do have characters of color in the book already. And yes, Locker Boy will be as diverse as Dork Diaries is. And then I guess it is makes sense where you kind of might not know that. Zoe's name is, and this is what I thought, Zoe's name is Zoisha Ebony Franklin, after Aretha Franklin. And then Chloe's name is, remember her name? Chloe. Yep, who knows Chloe's name? Yes? Garcia, there you go. So we're trying to give you hints, but unfortunately we work in pen and ink, and it's kind of black and white, and you know, so we kind of can't get all the you know, skin colors in there with just the black marker. And then we do have Asian characters. Can you think of the Asian character in the book? Anybody? Yes? Not Brandon. Yes? Thank you, Jenny Chen. Wow. Yeah, you're just an expert.
Wow.
Yes. Yes. And then we have person, I would say probably the Jewish faith, and his name is Theodore Swagmeyer. Yes, so we kind of, and again, it's really hard just looking at the book because everything's like black and white or whatever. So, but yes, I am committed to diversity, and Dork Diary is very diverse, and yes, Locker Boy will be very diverse. And that's a very good question, and thank you for answering it.
I actually don't have a question. I have more of a statement. Mm-hmm. I want to thank you for this series. I mean, I have children that are pretty adamant about reading, and when my daughter first came home and said, well, what's this, can I get Dork Diaries? I'm like, what?
Mm-hmm. That's a weird name even. What, it's like, Dork, what's up with that?
So when I finally looked at it, I said, oh, this is pretty cool. Mm-hmm. And then you came with all these books and all these books, and she's so passionate about the series. She did chores, extra chores, to buy the book
for
herself.
Well, good for you, Mom!
And I'm saying, yes, no problem. I will take it to the bookstore. So I just wanted to say thank you.
Well, thank you very, very much. Thank you. Thank you all. We're going to... Did you have a question, ma'am?
Just really quickly. Mm-hmm. Are you selling books here today?
I think I was told there was a bookseller outside the door.
Right
outside the door. I think is it Politics and Prose? Yes, thank you, Politics and Prose, but they are selling our books today. So if you don't have a book, and I think they're selling, is it all the books or just book eight? They're selling all of them, so you can buy the whole series. Wow, you're so lucky people today. So what we're going to do next is Nikki's going to do our dorkifications and give those out. After that, we're going to ask you to line up probably at this side here. You don't have to move now, but don't rush. Don't worry. If we have to be here till 1 a.m. in the morning signing your books, we are going to sign your book. So you don't have to rush or panic or anything. So, okay. You ready, Nikki?
I am ready, Rachel. Okay. Getting so excited, I'm getting choked.
Yeah.
Okay. Take a drink of water later. All right, so our very first Dorkification goes to a young lady in a purple fuzzy jacket. And can you all see it? You want me to put it in the middle? Okay, okay.
Is that better?
She is in a purple jacket, and she had the very first question of the day. Come on up and get your picture. Is it Camille? Camila, come on over, Camila. You're very welcome. There you go. You are very welcome, Camila. This next one belongs to a young lady with beautiful long braids, and she's wearing a bright green headband and earrings. She also has on a pink purse. Do you know who you are? Yep, come on over. Come on over. There you are. Yay!
Can we ask the first person to come up and we'll line you up and you can hold up your picture?
There you go.
Okay. So the person that had the first is Camila. Yep, if you can stand up here and you can stand here.
Next, next we have a young lady with the most beautiful frizzalicious long ponytails, and she is, I think she's kind of against the wall there. Yes, yeah, standing on her tippy toes in a navy t-shirt. Come on over and get your picture. Oh, it's a navy, is that what they call a jumper, Mommy? Yes, and a pretty little navy jumper. There you go. Oh, whoops. There you go. Okay. Next, we have a young lady with nice, long, beautiful black ponytail. And she has on a pink t-shirt with black and white little designs on it. And I think there's a word across the pink t-shirt. There you are. There you go. Oh, it says Puma. Okay. Okay, now this picture belongs to a young lady with the most marvelous long, long ponytail. And she asked me a question tonight. Is she still here? Let's see here. I think, what did she ask me? She asked me, do I like Chloe or Zoe better? And I said, I like both. There you are! Come on over! Yay! There you are. You're very welcome. Okay, next we have a young lady who is wearing a fuzzy, is it turquoise blue jacket? Yay! Come on up here and get your picture. There you are. You're welcome. And unfortunately, those are all the dorkifications I could do for tonight. I wish I could dorkify you all. But the good news is we're going to start our book signing part of the night now. So please feel free to come up and get your book signed.
Okay. Mm-hmm. Yeah, you guys want to? Yeah, if you want to. Yeah. Okay, you guys want to.